Welcome back, friends. In today's lecture, I am going to explain you about merits and demerits in Bentham and Hooker classification. I am going to explain you in detail about each point. Now let's begin with merits. Bentham and Hooker classification, it is a natural system by which actual examination of live specimens and preserved herbarium sheets. The description of plant is quite accurate and reliable without microscopic studies as well as at molecular level. As it is easy to follow, it is used as key for identification of plants in Kew herbaria as well as several herbaria in the world. In India, plants are arranged according to this classification only. We should feel very proud upon it. Yeah. Although it is a natural system, it does not incorporate phylogeny. For example, the order Ranales, which is the first order in the arrangement of plant, which is a primitive position in this system, and grasses, which is placed at the end of this classification. Researchers' findings says that this Ranales are the, means it is a primitive group of angiosperm. They have accepted it. The placement of monocotyledon after dicotyledonae, where they form a great changes, means the monocots which are derived from dicots, where the scientists have, means taxonomic findings says it is accepted. Their view has been accepted and they have supported this view. So I need your support. So do subscribe to my channel after watching this video. Now let's discuss what are the demerits in this system. This system does not incorporate phylogeny, although it was published after Darwin published his evolutionary theory. This is one of the greatest demerits in this system. The placement of gymnosperm between dicotyledonae and monocotyledonae. This is one of the error and has not been accepted. It means it is not acceptable and satisfactory. Most of the means most important floral characters have been neglected in this system. We have to see each and every part of the flower, but it has been neglected in the system that I am going to say. Let's see. Okay. The closely related families are not placed near, they are apart. This is also a great demerit. Yeah. And in this system, the closely related families are separated and placed under different groups, orders, cohorts. Yeah, I am going to explain. Now let's see one of the example I am going to say, that is all the families of series Carbembriae of Monoclamidae related to the Caryophyllaceae of series Calamiflorae of Polypetale. Now one more example means the unrelated families are grouped nearer, they are kept nearer to this, such as example for this is Podostomaceae of series, that is multivobulate aquaticae of Monoclamidae deserves place in Rosales of series Calciflorae of Polypetale. One more example, that is Lauraceae of series Daffanales Monocotyledonae deserves place in Ranales of series Thalamiflorae of Polypetalae. The closely related families, that is Podostomaceae and Lauraceae, are separated. We can see they have been separated, they are not kept very near. Yeah. Monocotyledonae as a subclass is considered to be an artificial group. It has become difficult to place closely related families such as Chinopodaceae and Caryophyllaceae to close to each other. This is also a demerit. And one of the absurd, practically absurd point, that is, generally we all know Polypetalous characteristic feature. Polypetalous means the perium, two perium with three petals. Whereas Phlogotaceae, Azoaceae, Mulugineaceae. In this, the flowers showing only one kind of perium, where they deserve a place in Monocotyledonae instead of being present in somewhere else. And another practically observed feature is, generally we all know Cucurbitaceae flowers are, they are fused, we all know. Means they are to be placed in Gamopetalae, but they are placed somewhere else. This is also a great demerit and misleading errors. And we all know Nepenthaceae of series Multivovulate Terrestrial of Monocotyledonae is closely related to Sarsinaceae of odd or pterygales of Thalamiflorae. They are very close to each other, but they are separated. And we all know the monocots, which are unnatural and unphylogeny in this system. These are the main things about the merits and demerits in this system. I hope, guys, this video is helpful. If you like my video, please don't forget to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I need your support continuously, so I feel very happy. Thank you.